These people are amongst the greatest quiz players in Britain. Together, they make up the Eggheads, arguably the most formidable quiz team in the country. The question is, can they be beaten? Welcome to Eggheads, the show where a team of five quiz challengers pit their wits against possibly the greatest quiz team in Britain. They are the Eggheads. And taking on our awesome general knowledge geniuses today are Quinn's Crafty Quizzers from Cardiff. Now, this team of friends are all associated with their local football club, Grange Harlequins AFC. Let's meet them.
Hi, I'm Steve. I'm 61 and I'm a part-time business development director.
Hi, I'm Terry. I'm 64 and I'm a retired telecommunications engineer.
Hi, I'm Ken. I'm 65 and I'm a part-time engineer.
Hi, I'm Neil. I'm 55. I'm a retired post office worker.
Hi, I'm Malcolm. I'm 61 and an operational manager in local government.
Steve and team, welcome.
Hi. Hi.
Good to see you. And tell us about the Quins, Steve.
Well, the Quins were a local Cardiff side who sort of played their football on Saturday afternoon parks and managed to move their way through the pyramid system right to the top division in Wales. They're no longer in the top division, sadly, but we've spent a lifetime playing or supporting them.
And it's gratifying to go and cheer them on still, is it?
It is, although sometimes there's not too much to cheer, but on a good day, there's plenty to cheer.
Now, I gather you're not quizzers in the sense that you quiz together a lot, is that right?
We've quizzed once, Jeremy, just once.
But I've looked at all your biographies and you've all got passions, actually, haven't you? There's a squeeze fan down here somewhere, just like me. Let's hope they come up. So you've got different knowledge, different interests.
Yes.
Well, good luck. Every day there is £1,000 worth of cash up for grabs for our challengers. However, if they fail to defeat the Eggheads, the prize money rolls over to the next show. So, Quinn's Crafty Quizzers, the challengers won the last game, which proves it can be done, and that means £1,000 says you can't beat the Eggheads. Do you want to start?
Yes, please, Jeremy.
OK, the first head-to-head battle is on the subject of geography. So, Quinns, who would like this?
Geography, who's going to be the first sacrificial lamb, then?
Who is? Looks like you, Terry.
Terry, Jeremy, we're going to put a star on first. We're going to have Terry on first.
OK, Terry on geography, and you can choose an egghead. Here they all are, grinning madly.
I think Daphne.
You were pretty sudden about that. You're definite about it.
I definitely, yeah. No matter what happened, there was
Jeremy, it's ambition to play against Daphne.
It's ambition, yes. So the geography's got nothing to do with it. Okay, Terry from Quinn's Crafty Quizzes versus Daphne from the Eggheads. To ensure there is no conferring, would you please take your positions in the question room? So, geography, Terry, you ready?
I'm ready.
Any particular places you've loved visiting in the world?
The Grand Canyon, Canada. I'd like to go to Australia, but I haven't been there yet. So.
But you love North America, do you?
North America, yeah.
What was great about the Grand Canyon?
Everything. Well, especially when I flew over it. In a plane.
And what is it, everything you imagine?
Even more. You read about these places, and until you actually visit them, you don't know how inspiring they are, you know?
Yeah, a photo doesn't really do it, does it?
No, no.
Daphne, you've been to the Grand Canyon?
Yes, twice. Once on my honeymoon, and we went again in 2004.
Yeah, it's awe-inspiring, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, good luck in this round. And Terry, you can choose. Would you like to go first or second?
I'd like to go first, please, Jeremy.
Here we go with your first set of questions. Good luck. The Scottish town of Perth was reinstated as a city to commemorate what event? Is it the birth of Prince William, Queen's Diamond Jubilee, or the Millennium?
I'm thinking... not too sure of this one at all, but I'm thinking it's a millennium.
Daphne, do you know?
It's the Queen's Diamond Jubilee.
Yes, it was the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. Okay, Daphne, New Zealand takes its name from a region of which country? Netherlands, Sweden, or Belgium?
That's the Netherlands.
Yeah, I see it now. I never knew that. Okay, Netherlands is right. Terry, try and catch up now. Which city was the capital of the traditional French province of Limousin? Is it Lille, Lyon, or Limoges?
I would... Once again, I'm not too sure this, but I think it would Limoges.
Limoges is the right answer, yeah. You've got it.
Well done, Terry.
Now, hang on. We've got a prefab sprout fan here. You know the connection?
No.
This is a very obscure thing. Their first single was called Lions in My Own Garden, Exit Someone. and that's because he liked going to Limoges, and those were the...
Really?
Yeah, yeah. So then when I see Limoges, I always think prefab Sprout.
Ah.
And I saw that you were a Sprout fan. Lions in my own garden.
Obviously not as big a fan as you,
no,
Jeremy.
I'm a big fan, big fan. Okay, Daphne. Ithaca, New York is the home of which US university? Is it Princeton, Cornell, or Brown? To take the lead.
I think Brown is Rhode Island. Princeton. I think it's Cornell.
Cornell is the right answer. This is the disadvantage of playing Daphne Terry. You're seeing right now, there are many advantages, but the big disadvantage is that she tends to get the answers right. So you need this one. Which of these US states has a border with Canada? Terry, is it Nebraska, Utah, or Vermont?
Once again, my first inkling is for Vermont, so I think I'll go for Vermont.
Yeah, brilliant, you got it right. All that American travel helped you. Vermont is right. So, Daphne, if you get this one right, you are in the final round. Olcon Island, with an area of around 730 square kilometers, is the largest island in which lake? Is it Baikal, Malawi, or Huron?
Could you spell it?
Yes, Olcon is O-L-K-H-O-N. Olcon.
O-L, yes. I think that's Lake Baikal.
The correct answer is Baikal. Well done, Daphne. Terry, sorry, you were beaten by our egghead, and as a result, you won't be able to help your team in the final round. Terry and Daphne, please return to us. So, as it stands, Quinn's crafty quizzers have lost one brain from the final round, whilst the eggheads haven't lost any. So, any thoughts on strategy, Steve? You're a football-supporting team. Maybe you want to change positions.
We actually set Terry up as the sacrificial lamb because the other four are going to cruise in now. I think that's the tactic.
OK, maybe five in midfield or...
maybe, yeah, yes, yes. Stop their attack, I think.
Stop the attack, OK. Yeah. That's always hard to do with this team over here, but let's see how you go. The next subject is film and television. So who would like this? Film and TV.
Yeah, go on there, you do it, son.
I'll take it, gentlemen.
Neil, against anyone but Daphne.
Chris, maybe.
Chris, yeah.
Chris, I think so.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, okay.
We'll take on Chris, please, Jeremy.
Chris, how does that feel?
Feels better than sport.
So Neil from Quinn's Crafty Quizzes versus Chris from the Eggheads. And to ensure there's no conferring, would you please take your positions in the question room? So Neil, film and television for you. Any particular programmes you love?
I like a bit of the American drama series more than most, you know. That's what I like.
So what, The Wire and all that kind of?
Yeah, that type of thing. Anything criminal.
Criminal?
Criminal, yeah.
What about you, Chris, on those American ones? 6 Feet Under, The Wire, Sopranos, all of those.
Used to watch The Sopranos, don't watch any others. I mean, my current American weakness is actually The Big Bang Theory.
Oh, well, tell us about that.
Oh, it's a comedy, basically, about four postgraduate geeks, and you know, it's a frothy American comedy, but it's quite good fun. And of course, all the scientific jargon they come out with is not gobbledygook, it is proper scientific stuff.
Okay, well, let's see how you do. Film and television, and Neil, you can choose the first or second set of questions.
I'll go first, Jeremy, please.
Here we go. Rachel Stevens, Anita Dobson, and Felicity Kendall have all appeared as contestants on which TV show? Is it Strictly Come Dancing, Celebrity Big Brother, or Fame Academy?
I think that's Strictly Come Dancing, Jeremy.
Strictly Come Dancing is the right answer. Well done. Chris, your question. Joss Shimmy Gibbs, James Norrington, and Tia Dalma are characters from which film franchise? Is it Indiana Jones, Pirates of the Caribbean, or Toy Story?
Well, it's not Indiana Jones, is it? And it's not Toy Story, so it's got to be Pirates of the Caribbean.
Pirates of the Caribbean is also right. One each. Neil, Joaquin Phoenix was nominated for a Best Actor Oscar for his role in which 2012 film? Is it Zero Dark Thirty, The Master, or Django Unchained?
I know it's not Django Unchained. I do believe it's The Master, Jeremy.
You think it's The Master? I think your team disagree here. What do you think, guys?
I thought it was Django Unchained. That's what I thought.
Yeah. Team, I'm glad you're not in there, because Neil has got it right.
Well, Neil.
The Master is the right answer.
Yeah, Neil.
Minority of one, but right. How rewarding. Chris, which character from Little Britain has the catchphrase, I'm a lady? Is it Vicky Pollard, Carol Beer, or Emily Howard?
Yeah, that's David Walliams as Emily Howard.
It is indeed Emily Howard. Mm. I'm a lady. You can do it better than me, can't you?
No.
Go on.
Yes, well, I'm a lady.
Right, so two each. Neil, who played the title role in the US sitcom According to Jim? Was this James Gandolfini, James Caan, or James Belushi?
Ooh, it was definitely a James. I think I'll go for James Belushi.
James Belushi is right. Ooh. Well played. Okay, so you're on the edge here, Chris. If you get this one wrong, you are not in the final round. Angela Lansbury received her first Oscar nomination for which film? Is it Gaslight, Samson and Delilah, or The Harvey Girls?
Was she in Samson and Delilah? Was it Victor Mature? The Harvey Girls, that's a fairly lightweight musical about setting up restaurant cars on the Atchison, Topeka and Santa Fe. Don't think she was in Samson and Delilah, but I've no idea she was in Gaslight, which is a drama and might have attracted an award, so I'll say Gaslight.
Gaslight is the right answer. Mm. Very good logic there. So three questions each, the scores are level, we go to sudden death. Neil, it's a bit harder, I don't give you alternative answers, OK?
Yep.
Jeremy Piven took on the title role in which TV drama series first shown in the UK in January 2013?
Oh, I don't even think I can give you an answer for that, Jeremy. No, I'll pass. I can't even think of one.
Not even a guess?
No, sorry, Jeremy.
Okay, that's a pass. Mr. Selfridge is the answer. So here we go. Chris, your question for the round. Which American sitcom starring John Lithgow featured four extraterrestrials who pretended to live as a family on Earth?
This was great fun. It was one of my favourites. It's Third Rock from the Sun.
Third Rock from the Sun is the right answer. Well done, Chris. You're in the final round. Sorry, Neil, just at the very end, he pipped you there.
Yep.
So you've been knocked out as well. Please, both of you, come back and rejoin your teammates. So, as it stands, Quinn's crafty quizzes have now lost two brains from the final round. The Eggheads are still intact. The next subject is arts and books. Who would like this?
Ooh. We didn't want arts and books. See the meal, Malcolm. Do you want it?
I haven't got a clue.
No, particularly.
So which one of us then?
That may have to be me, I suppose, a sacrificial lamb.
Go on, Ken. I think you're going to have inspiration. Yeah.
Yep. Okay. I'll take it on, Jeremy.
Okay, Ken and anyone but Chris or Daphne, so... Who would you like?
I'll take Dave, please.
OK, so Ken from Quinn's Crafty Quizzes versus Tremendous Knowledge Dave from the Eggheads. Please go to the question room now. Ken, I'm thinking you want Charles Dickens to come up.
It would be something I might stand a chance with, I think, Jeremy, but I'll just wait and see what you can throw at me and hope for the best.
Because you read a lot of Dickens, have you?
I watched a lot of the Dickens, and I've started reading Dickens to my grandchildren. To try and get them interested in books.
OK, Ken, good luck. Arts and books, and would you like the first or second set of questions?
I'll go first again, please, Jeremy.
So here we go, good luck. William Wordsworth was appointed Poet Laureate in which year? Ken, was it 1743, 1843 or 1943?
It was definitely not 1943. And I'm thinking that 1743 is a bit early. So I'm going to plump for down the middle and go for 1843.
1843 is the right answer.
Well done, Ken.
Yeah, okay. Okay, Dave. In Victor Hugo's Les Misérables, Jean Valjean is given a long prison sentence for stealing what? Chicken, loaf of bread, or bottle of brandy?
I don't know. I'll have to go loaf of bread, but I'm not no. certainty about it. Les Miserables is not something that I've got into at all.
Let's go to our musicals correspondent, Daphne Fowler.
Yes.
Is he right?
He's completely right.
Well, you would have been in pain if he got that wrong. But you're right anyway. Loaf of bread is the right answer.
I will go and see the film now.
Go with Daphne.
Will do.
OK, Ken, the Welsh-born artist Barry Flanagan, who died in 2009, was best known for his series of large brass sculptures of which creatures? Is it squirrels, hares, or badgers?
Well, this is one that I don't really know. I'm trying to think logically what you would sculpt. I can't see hares being... I would go, and it is a total guess, to be honest, but I would go for badgers.
It's not badgers, actually. Oh. It is hares.
Oh.
Large brass sculptures of hares. OK, Dave, to take the lead, the Diagram Prize is awarded to books with what type of title? Is it the longest, the saddest, or the oddest?
I need a diagram to describe it. It's either oddest or longest, I would have thought, but... So I'm just thinking the longest title would be hard to quantify. People could just write something with 100 things. I'll go oddest, but no certainty on this at all.
Oddest is the right answer. Oh, that is the Diagram Prize. Oddest titles. OK, Ken, you need to get this one right. In Shakespeare's Hamlet, which character says, "This above all, to thine own self be true"? Is it Polonius, Horatio, or Claudius?
I'm no great shakes on Shakespeare. Again, I'm going to have a guess. I'm trying to see if I... Obviously, I recognise a few of the names there. The one I'm looking at is Polonius, so I'm going to go for Polonius.
Polonius is correct.
Well, Ken.
OK, Dave. The Rhyme Royal, a stanza with 7 lines, was introduced into English poetry by which writer? Is it Alexander Pope, Edmund Spenser, or Geoffrey Chaucer?
Rhyme is spelled R-H-Y-M-E?
Yeah.
Rhyme Royal. I'll go Alexander Pope.
Eggheads don't like that answer. Which is it?
Chaucer.
The stanza with 7 lines was Geoffrey Chaucer, so sorry, Dave, you got one wrong. Does mean you're level, though.
Yep.
So we go to sudden death again, Ken. I don't give you alternatives, OK?
Yep.
The Munk Museum, dedicated to the life and works of the artist Edvard Munk, is located in which city?
Well, I got a feeling that he was Norwegian, so I'm going to plump for Oslo.
That's very good. You're right. Oslo is the right answer. And if you got it wrong, you could have done the scream.
I'm doing it anyway.
Dave, to stay in, Kazuo Ishiguro, author of the novels Remains of the Day and Never Let Me Go, was born in which country?
Japan.
Japan is right. OK, back to you. Ken, the 12th day of July is the first in a series of books featuring a couple called Kevin and Sadie during the Troubles in Belfast by which Scottish author?
Oh, gosh, Scottish author. I'm struggling to think of Scottish authors. The name that's coming into my head is Ian Banks, but I know it's not Ian Banks. But I got nothing else to offer, so I'm going to have to say Ian Banks.
It's not Ian Banks, it's Joan Lingard.
No.
OK, this for the round, Dave. A 19-year-old Yorkshireman named William Fisher is the title character of which 1959 comic novel?
Billy Liar.
Billy Liar by Keith Waterhouse is the right answer. Well done. Dave, you're in the final round. Sorry, Ken, you've been knocked out. Played well, though, but you won't be in that final. Come back, and we will see what happens next. As it stands, Quinn's crafty quizzers have lost 3 brains from the final round. Gulp. Whilst the Eggheads have not lost any so far. But there's still hope. You can win, for sure. The next subject is sport. Who would like this?
I think, Malcolm, it has to be you.
Yep, has to be me.
I want to see you back with me.
Who are we going to play with?
Barry,
please.
OK, so Malcolm from Quinn's Crafty Quizzes versus Barry from the Eggheads on sport. And to ensure there's no conferring, please go to the question room. So, Malcolm, you've got unusual taste in sport, I know.
I actually like American baseball. My other half has a girlfriend in Baltimore, and we've been going out for the last 10 or 12 years, and girls, as girls do, go shopping. and me disappearing off the baseball for 2.5, 3 or 4 hours with a beer and some popcorn is rather good. So I'm a converted Baltimore Orioles fan.
That's just fantastic. So do you manage to watch them when you're back in the UK, or is that a bit difficult?
That's a bit more difficult, but one of the first jobs in the morning is actually to go online and find out how they've got on the night before. The bad news is they lost 4-3 last night, so they're now 3-3.
Oh, well, we do occasionally have baseball questions coming up, don't we, Barry?
We do indeed, yes.
So you're looking nervous now, Barry.
We shall see.
Let's see what happens. Sport, Malcolm, would you like to go first or second?
I'll go first, please.
Here we go. Good luck. In 2009, which tennis player became father to the twins Myla Rose and Charlene Riva? Is it Andy Murray, Roger Federer, or Joe Wilfried Tsonga?
Well, it certainly isn't Andy Murray. No, Roger Federer or Joe Wilfried. I think I'm going to go with Roger Federer.
It is indeed Roger Federer. Well done. Well done. OK, Barry. At the 2012 London Olympics, Jessica Ennis broke the UK national record for her performance in which discipline of the heptathlon? Is it the high jump, 100 metres hurdles or javelin?
I believe this was the 100 metres hurdles.
100 metres hurdles is the right answer. Second question to you, Malcolm. The Brazilian footballer Givanildo Vieira de Souza, who signed for Zenit St. Petersburg in 2012, is usually known by which nickname? Kaká, Ronaldo or Hulk?
Definitely not Ronaldo. It's either Kaká or the Hulk. I think I'm going to go with the Hulk.
Hulk is correct. OK, Barry, your question to stay in contention. Which Australian rugby league team beat Leeds Rhinos in the 2013 World Club Challenge? Was it the Gold Coast Titans, Sydney Roosters or Melbourne Storm?
Do I have to say the answer to this question? It pains me immensely to say this, but unfortunately it was Melbourne Storm.
Melbourne Storm is right. Was that painful for you as a Leeds person?
It is indeed. And unfortunately, they were worth the victory as well.
Where did that take place, that match?
It was at Headingley.
Right, did you go?
No, I didn't, unfortunately. I couldn't make it that night.
OK. Yeah.
Well, just as well.
Melbourne Storm is right. Of course, we didn't know you were going to play this round, so nobody's teasing you, I promise. OK, Malcolm, who was the trainer of Shergar when he won the Epsom Derby in 1981? Is it Michael Stout, Vincent O'Brien or Dick Hearn?
Ooh, blimey. 1981, Shergar. Michael Stout was about, certainly Vincent O'Brien was. Dick Hearn, I think I'm going to go with Vincent O'Brien because somewhere in the back of my mind, he was the most successful of the lot.
Anyone know?
Yeah. It's Vincent O'Brien.
Yeah, you all think so?
Yeah.
How interesting. Do you think so, Barry?
I thought it was Vincent O'Brien.
No, it's not. It's Michael Stout.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. But if there's any consolation, Malcolm, all the eggheads agree with you. And they're all wrong, too.
And all the quins.
How unfair is that? Oh, you all agree, too, do you? Yeah. OK, all the quins as well. Right, Barry, if you get this one right, you're in the final round. In which sport is the Espirito Santo trophy played for every 2 years? Is it table tennis, golf or ice hockey?
It's certainly not table tennis. Espirito Santo. I don't think it's ice hockey. I believe it's golf.
Golf is the correct answer. So you have 3 points and Malcolm, sorry, you've got two, which means Barry has gone through to the final round and you're going to be reduced to one in the final. Quins, but let's see how you do. Both of you please come back and we'll play that final round. OK, Steve, what happens now?
Well, Jeremy, it reminds me a bit of the Randy Newman album Lonely at the Top. So I'm in it on my own, but Who knows?
This is what we have been playing towards. It is time for the final round, which, as always, is general knowledge. But I'm afraid those of you who lost your head-to-heads won't be allowed to take part in this round. So, Terry, Ken, Neil and Malcolm from Quinn's Crafty Quizzes, would you please now leave the studio? So, Steve, you are playing to win Quinn's Crafty Quizzes £1,000. Dave, Daphne, Chris, Barry and Pat, you are playing for something which money can't buy, the Eggheads' reputation. As usual, I will ask each team three questions in turn. This time the questions are all general knowledge. You are allowed to confer. I'm sorry that doesn't help you. Steve, the question is your one brain better than the Eggheads' five? And would you like to go first or second?
Jeremy, I think I'll go second because it'll take me longer to get the answers wrong. So I think we'll go second.
OK, good luck to both teams, but especially our challenger. Eggheads, what is the English meaning of the Latin phrase Deo volente? Is it time flies, whichever you like, or God willing?
God willing. Yeah.
That's God willing, Jeremy.
God willing is the right answer. OK, Steve, your question. Who released the 2012 album Take the Crown, which reached number one in the UK charts? Ollie Mers, Justin Bieber or Robbie Williams?
Well, it certainly wasn't Robbie Williams, so I'm left between Justin Bieber and Ollie Mers. I'll go for Ollie Mers, Jeremy.
Actually, you know what? It was Robbie.
Was it?
It was Robbie Williams. Robbie Williams is the right answer. So, Eggheads, what is the name of the Radio 4 program which is broadcast regularly at 5 o'clock on weekday afternoons? Is it PM, Evening Extra, or Drive?
PM.
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 Yeah.
PM.
PM. I'm assured with confidence that it's PM.
You don't know yourself, Pat?
No, no, that means nothing.
Not a Radio 4 man?
Not really, no.
More Radio 2, I'm thinking.
Radio 3.
I'm hearing Radio 2?
Radio 2, Radio 2, Jerry, sorry. Sorry.
PM is the right answer. Steve, in which country does the annual Westminster Kennel Club dog show take place? And you need to get this one right to stay in the contest. Is it Canada, USA, or Australia?
Now, where might there be a Westminster amongst that lot? Probably everywhere, I should imagine. I will go for, and it's a complete guess, I'll go for USA, Jeremy.
I'm so glad you did, it's right. USA is the right answer. So the score is 2 to the Eggheads and 1 to the challenger. As you let them go first, if they get this one right, it is curtains. But they can get things wrong, and it's really funny when they do. Which British scientist helped Christopher Wren rebuild London after the Great Fire and is thought to have worked on designs for the Royal Greenwich Observatory and Bedlam Hospital? Is it Isaac Newton, Humphrey Davy, or Robert Hooke?
I think it's
Robert Hooke. I think it's Robert Hooke.
Yeah. I think it's Hooke too.
Yeah.
He was involved with the monument. Yeah. I think it must
the
be.
The dates are entirely wrong for Davy, haven't
they? Yeah,
we always
never heard the other ones.
It's almost a clue anyway.
Yeah. We're going to go for Robert Hooke.
Well, they do look certain, don't they?
They look certain.
And they are right, it is Robert Hooke. So we say congratulations, Eggheads, you have won. So what you've got to do now is anywhere you walk past a shop or a car, Robbie Williams music, hands over the ears.
I never did like Robbie Williams and I can't stand the man now, so no, I don't think so.
But well played, Steve, well played. Team, sorry you were left on your own there. It does happen quite a lot. Commiserations to Quinn's Crafty Quizzes. The Eggheads have done what comes naturally to them and they reign supreme over Quizland once again. I'm afraid it does mean you won't be going home with the £1,000, so the prize money rolls over to our next show. Eggheads, congratulations. Who will beat you? Join us next time to see if a new team of challengers have the brains to defeat the Eggheads. £2,000 says they don't. Till then, goodbye.
Well, you don't get many chances to blow dry a hen, but it's Michael Portillo's turn. Great British Railway Journey's next. Then four very old living rooms get a brand new look to Dorset for the Great Interior Design Challenge. And did a couple manage to restore their Georgian mansion to its former glory? A year on, we'll find out at 8.